Moving on to the next line in our code, we see that running the new saga function should have the effect of creating a new execution context, so that it can make room for new variables that are local to that function call. Then, the new context will become the interpreter's new current context for as long as that function is running. This first line will add a new variable to the current scope. The next line adds another variable to the red scope, this time holding a function value. At this point, we'll have to do a lookup on the saga variable in order to know which function these parens are attempting to call. The interpreter handles this by checking whether the name saga has any meaning in its current context, the red context. The interpreter checks the scope of the current execution context and finds that the saga variable is available locally in that red scope. The value found there is a function object, and the parens next to the word saga tell the interpreter to invoke that function. Running the saga function will build a new execution context and move the interpreter's lookup focus into it. The first line adds a new variable to that local scope, and now we do lookups on all three of our variables. Again, the interpreter will do this by scanning outward from its current context, looking for the closest containing context that can satisfy a requested name. First, it goes looking for hero, which can't be found in the containing context, and so it falls through. Falling through to the red context, the interpreter does not find a hero variable there either. Finally, falling all the way through to the global context, the variable is found there. The string being logged is beginning to get built up. Next, it goes looking for the deed variable. What will be the output of that lookup?